I hope you're all hanging in there during this challenging time. We all need to really focus right now on keeping our mind, body, and spirit healthy. And so I'm combining some of my favorite things in order to keep that going during this time of social distancing. So many of you know I'm an author, but I'm also a Pilates teacher, and I found a lot of benefits in Pilates. It's all about strength and balance and control, especially the core, so abdominal muscles. So I've been combining two of my favorite things, reading and Pilates, lately. So I wanted to show you some tricks and just a couple Pilates moves you can do right at home, if you have a mat or even on the carpet, whatever, just to keep your body strong during this time, and also just to kind of find some fun escapism in reading. So today I'm featuring this book I've been reading, Sarah McKenzie's Forever Friends. It's a really fun story about female friendship. Two women who are at different points in their lives. One's a young mom and one has a daughter who just went off to college. And they're finding this amazing bond when they're at this crossroads in their lives. There's fun romance in it, and there's just a lot of really positive female friendship vibes. So I highly recommend this book. It's a great escape right now. And I'm gonna be showing you how I do Pilates when I read. So just a couple simple exercises even you can do at home. So today I'm gonna focus on our side leg series, a hallmark Pilates move. And to do that, we're just gonna lay down on your mat or on the carpet on your side. You want your hips stacked and your core is engaged. So we focus a lot on the core in Pilates to keep the back and the spine strong. And then just also balance comes from the center of the body, control, strength. So those are all things we focus on in Pilates. So you're gonna move your legs a little bit out in front of you. I have my toes at the edge of the mat, as you can see. And this is called our side leg series. So we're gonna start just by raising the top leg about to hip height. We wanna keep the hips stacked. You wanna pull the abdominal wall in, so nice and tight through those abdominals. And then bottom obliques are pulling away from the mat here. And then it's just a really simple focus on these outer thighs, outer hips, outer glutes as we work and read at the same time. As you can see, you can hold the book right in front of you. And then we're just gonna start by tapping the heel in front and toe behind. So very simple move here, but we're changing the rotation of the foot and we're really lengthening through the legs, starting to warm up those lower body muscles. So feeling the lower body here. Of course, we're still using the core for control. So once we start with that little warm up, just with the heel tap, toe tap, then you're going to start to bring the leg up a little higher, tap it back behind you, up a little higher, tap the heel in front of you. So I recommend doing about maybe 10 to 15 reps here with the heel toe taps. And then we're gonna come in, we're gonna hold that leg about hip height, again, making sure hips are stacked, shoulders are straight, and then your ears are away from the shoulders, so we don't wanna hunch in the shoulders, we really want length in the neck here. And then just little circles, so flexing through the foot, little tiny circles, like you're drawing circles with that heel. We'll go here in one direction, and again, 10 to 15 is good for a rep. And then we're gonna point the toe, and we're gonna go in the other direction with circles. So small little circles with the feet. This whole time, you could be reading here. I'm not reading because I'm telling you how to do it, but this is when I read. I just hold the book in front of me and read. It kind of takes your mind off the pain. And then holding here, now we're gonna add a challenge in, a balance challenge. So you're gonna bring the leg forward and you're gonna bring the leg back. Now the key here is keeping those hips nice and steady while you move that top leg. And then we want length through the leg. So long through the leg, long through the torso here. You can feel those abdominal muscles working. We've got lower body and abs working here. And just again, 10 reps here is good. Beautiful. And then we're gonna pause here. One more thing to do. Now you're gonna start to feel it in this outer glute, outer hip area. So we want to just finish out here with some kicks. So pull it in, press through that heel. Pull in, press through the heel. You're keeping hips stacked again. Try not to move in those hips. We want the spine to stay in neutral here. And we're just moving through the leg. And again, 10 reps is good there. We'll stretch it out one more time, nice and long through the body. And then we'll bring the foot in front to the floor and find a good stretch here. So again, this is all stuff you can do while you're reading, combining mind and body work here. And then I'll be doing a video every couple days just to show you some new moves that you can do while you're at home, while you want to escape into a book, and also just keep your body strong and flexible with Pilates. So join me again, and I'll have a new book to review, a new book to talk about, and some new moves to show you. See you soon.